Hello and welcome again to another DSPB review. In this one, I'm reviewing the smartphone with the best, craziest specs ever, which you can get for 270 €. The Xiaomi Poco X3. Wait, 270 € with crazy good specs? There must be a catch. Is it the build quality? No, the build quality of this phone is surprisingly good for that low price. But what is it? Well, stick around for the next minutes to find out. First, let's start with the display. Xiaomi gives you 120Hz, yes, you heard that right, a 120Hz display for 270 €. And it is a really good one, which is also bright enough for using it in daylight. But what's so special about a 120Hz display? Well, once you have experienced one, you will never want to go back. Everything you do, like simple swiping, closing and opening apps and so on, looks super smooth and fluid. Using 120Hz needs a bit more battery power, but the battery of the Poco X3 is huge enough with 5160 mAh to handle that, and you can switch to 60Hz anytime if you want. But believe me, you will never switch to 60Hz back once you experienced 120Hz, especially when gaming on this very affordable beast. The Xiaomi Poco X3 features a very fast octa-core processor and 6 GB of RAM, so any game you throw on it will run very smooth, and with 120Hz it will look super smooth. This phone features USB-C speaker and also a headphone jack on the bottom. On the top you will find the second speaker for stereo and also a selfie camera notch with 20 megapixels and a fast f2.2 lens. You can make some really nice selfies too. The Poco X3 is great for multimedia, like watching videos, and the stereo speakers sound pretty good for the price. They are missing some bass low end, but the sound system uses the body of the smartphone, so it basically sounds like the sound is coming from all sides, which is great, and again, for that low price, this is definitely not what you usually get. On the right side of the phone you get a fingerprint sensor to unlock your smartphone, which works great. It's probably not the fastest, but like you can see here, it definitely does the job. Speaking of fast, this phone also gives you turbo charging, so you can quickly charge the huge 5160 mAh battery, which gives you enough juice for at least 2 days. The display features Corning Gorilla Glass 5, which is basically very nice, but I've noticed that it is very prone to fingerprints and dust. And also be aware of scratches, you should definitely use protective glass on top of it. And what else? Why is the price so cheap now? Okay, I will tell you. Xiaomi gives you these crazy specced out phones so affordable because they are displaying some ads on your phone. But the good news is, you can very easily turn all of that off. Go into your settings, passwords and security, and then to authorize and withdraw. And turn off MSA. This will basically turn off all data connection to Xiaomi. Now go into your apps, settings and system apps. Go into all of the system apps and turn off display recommendations. So you see, it is very easy to turn off all of that, and I would also recommend don't use the Xiaomi web browser. Just use Chrome, it's better anyway, and this should definitely not stop you from buying Xiaomi phones. Now what about the camera? Xiaomi gives you a very good Sony sensor, the IMX682 Quad Beta, and yes, that camera bump is huge. The camera app of the Poco is great. It gives you quick and also professional features for photos and videos. You can switch to the ultra wide lens and also to the macro lens anytime. And in the Pro mode you can also set your ISO, shutter speed, white balance for photos and video. You can activate the 64 megapixel mode and, very important, you can shoot in RAW. For video you even get a flat log profile, which is great, and also a histogram, zebras and focus peaking, so pretty much everything like in a mirrorless camera. Wait, 64 megapixel mode, how good is that? On the Poco X3 it is great. It is already good in the Xiaomi Mi Note 10 Lite, but on the Poco X3 it looks like they have improved the 64 megapixel mode. In that mode the Quad Beta sensor combines the pixels and creates a 64 megapixel JPEG, which looks very impressive for a smartphone. Although I would really appreciate it if Xiaomi would give us the option to save the results in RAW or at least in something better than JPEG. Saying that, you get really nice cropping possibilities and great detail already. One more thing I want to highlight here is the ultrawide sensor, which now has 13 megapixels. Now of course this will not replace your high-end mirrorless camera, and you can definitely see some distortion going on in the images. But this is really great to have in your pocket anytime you need it. And the lens is very sharp and the images are very detailed. The Xiaomi Poco X3 also can shoot 4K 30p, still not 60p unfortunately, but Xiaomi gives us amazing electronic stabilization instead. The samples you see here are all shot handheld without a gimbal. The results are not as super smooth like on a GoPro, but again, for the price of 270 euro, this is definitely impressive. Honestly, the Poco X3 is crazy good for the low price. Normally, you would definitely pay 3 times the price to get all the features of this smartphone. If you are looking for the best price-quality ratio on a smartphone in 2020, this is it. It probably can't get better than that. And if so, Xiaomi will do it again. If you liked this review, don't hold your mouse or smartphone like a schnitzel, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this YouTube channel. Thanks for watching, see you in the next one.